Good morning, everyone. How's it going today? Today, I'm going to be showing you how to build Open Cowork, which is basically the same thing as Claude Cowork, but running locally with local models. And I also have added a very quick integration with Hugging Face models through inference providers. But you can run this locally with Ollama. Actually, right here, I'm running locally with GPT OSS on Ollama. And as you can see, it asked me for permission to update my files in this directory. And now I'm going to ask it to organize the files into different folders like they do in the marketing video of Anthropic. So let me show you how it works. And there you go. It has finished organizing the whole thing. And it did all of that locally without ever sending my files to a remote cloud server. So let's see how to build this. Okay, so the first thing to consider is how Cowork actually works, because of course it is not open source, and they have actually given us a little bit of a hint about how it works. It's basically just a wrapper around Claude Code with a nice user interface, which is more geared towards non-technical people. And as you can see, how is Cowork different from a regular conversation with regular Claude? They say in Cowork, you give Claude access to a folder of your choosing on your computer, and Claude can read, edit, or create files in that folder on top of using some other MCP tools that they will be connected to. And that's basically Claude Code with a nice user interface. And that's what we're going to be working with right here, if you remember correctly. Here we have the nice little demo from Claude Code of Cowork fixing and organizing their desktop right here. So let's actually start building this. What I'm going to be doing is going through the high level abstractions of how this works. We're not going to be going in detail into every single part of the code, because you're most likely, if you're going to be building something like this, you're going to be using a coding assistant to do this. So we're going to keep this at a high level of abstraction to show you the components of the application, how they interact with each other, which services I'm using, and how you can build your own with the help of your own coding assistant, being Claude Code, Open Code, Codex, etc. Okay, so let's get right into it. All right, so let's go over the application flow. As I was telling you before, we're going to be doing this from a high level. We're not going to be going very deeply into the code, because I'm pretty sure that if you're going to be building this, you're going to be building it using a coding assistant. So the idea is that you know what you're building and how to describe it to your coding assistant. So the application flow is going to go like this. In case you have not used Claude Code or Cowork before, the first thing that they usually do is they ask you for access to a folder that they're going to be working with. And that's the first thing that we do. The first step is to grant folder access to your assistant. So what we're going to do is we're going to prompt the user to give us a path, a file path, just like this. And then we're going to add that file path to an allowed directories variable, which we're going to use to validate against every single command that our agent is going to try to run. Okay. Then the next thing, once we have the allowed directories set up, we're going to go into our main agent loop, which is basically just a while loop that is going to continue running up until we stop it, which is going to ask us for a task, and it is going to send that task to the agent, just like that. And then the agent is going to complete the task, and the agent is going to have access to three different tools. I'm going to explain them a little bit more in detail a little bit later in the video, but just know that we have a run shell tool, which basically runs bash commands. Then we're going to have a fetch URL tool, and then we're going to have a search web tool. So the agent is going to continue in that loop until it finishes the task. Okay, so now let's talk very quickly about the agent architecture that we're going to be using. We're going to be building the entire thing using OpenAI Agents SDK. And if you're not familiar with OpenAI Agents SDK, it's the OpenAI's SDK for creating agents, and it is completely open source, and it is very minimalist and very powerful. I actually have another video right here that shows you how to build agents using it. It's more of a crash course, so feel free to click on it. It's also linked in the description if you want. And the idea behind choosing OpenAI Agents SDK is, first of all, because it's very simple and straightforward. It makes it very easy to create agents. Also, it is not locked to OpenAI models, which means that you can run these agents with any model provider that you want. And that's what we need right here because we're going to be running our agent both with Olama and with Hugging Face. So very, very important. And of course, it has a built-in agent loop like pretty much any agent SDK. And what's going to happen is we're going to be using this adapter from OpenAI Agents SDK. Basically, it's this one right here that allows you to pass in a model object, a client object like this, which is an OpenAI-like object. And something cool about the OpenAI SDK is that you can pass in a base URL, which means that you can just use this setup to connect it to any OpenAI-like LLM to your agent, and it's going to just work. And that's what we're going to do. As I told you before, we're going to be using both Olama and Hugging Face inference providers using the Hugging Face router. And both of them, all that you need to do for both of them is to just change the base URL. So in the case of Hugging Face, it's router.huggingface.co/v1 that is going to automatically route you to the model that you want. Now, if you're going to be using Hugging Face inference providers, your data is, of course, going to go to these inference providers. I mean, any traces from your agent. If you want this to be completely local, you would have to run this in Olama. And also, pretty cool thing about Olama is that it runs a local server. So all you're going to have to do is change the base URL to localhost and then the port wherever you're running Olama/v1. And that's just going to work just like that. Okay. I'll show you in just a moment how it actually is working. But basically, once you have set up your agent, your model like that, then you pass in that model object that you created right here into your agent object that you created. And the agent object in OpenAI SDK is very straightforward. All that you have to do is define a name for it, which in this case, we named it Open Cowork. Then we create the instructions, which is a very long and detailed prompt about how it is supposed to behave. In our case, it is basically a clone of Cowork or Claude Code, and we basically just tell it what it can do, what tools it has access to, etc. And then we just define the tools that we're going to give it access to. And I'm going to give you a little bit more information about how to create these tools in just a moment. Okay, so we have successfully understood that first of all, we have to grant access to your agent to a given directory, and then how to create your agent using OpenAI SDK and how to connect it to basically any LLM provider that you want that is compatible with the OpenAI API. And the next thing to do is to define the tools that we're going to be building. And this is a little bit different than how you would usually do it or how I have seen many people do it, which is that they would create multiple tools for every single specific action. So an agent like this, somebody would probably create a read file tool, then a write file, then a list directory tool, etc. So you would have a lot of different tools, each one with a very specific action. And you would, of course, have to maintain these tools differently and independently. And this would also mean that you would have a lot of different tool definitions in your context from the start of your application, which is probably not what you want to do. A better approach to do this is to create a single tool which would run shell commands. It is, of course, a little bit more dangerous, so you would have to take the required precautions to do this, but it is much more flexible and useful and powerful, of course. It basically allows your agent to run shell commands and to move things around, to list them, to see, to explore your file system and run even scripts if you want. So very, very powerful. So in our case, we're building this thing with three different tools and only three. One for running the shell commands, another one for fetching URLs, basically just gets the contents of a website. It uses Beautiful Soup. And then we have a search web command, which uses the DuckDuckGo package. Very straightforward. For the run shell command, it is a very important thing to do that you have to validate every single thing. And this is, of course, just a tutorial. In a more production-like scenario, you would have much more secure guardrails. In this case, we're just validating a command against an allow list. And then second thing that we're doing is validating that the paths in that command are within the validated commands that we have, sorry, the validated paths that we have defined before when we granted access to our directory at the beginning of the workflow. And then by the end, we just run the entire sub-process if we actually validated the whole thing. Again, I cannot stress this enough. This is not enough security for production. This is just a demo. In production, you would have to run this in a sandbox or in a Docker container to make sure that none of your files are in actual danger from any misbehavior from your agent. In this case, as I was telling you, we created a command allow list. So the allowed commands are the only commands that our agent is able to run. And we also disabled path reversal and also some sensitive paths. So it cannot go backwards in the directory tree, and it can only access the paths that we have defined. The second tool that we're going to be using is fetch URL. Super straightforward. Basically, we just import beautiful soup and we just scrape the contents of that given URL and return it in simple text. Very straightforward. And the next tool is Search Web. For this one, we're using DuckDuckGo from DDJS, which is the official package for DuckDuckGo. And yeah, very straightforward. We just run the query and list the results and then just let the agent choose to fetch the URLs that it wants to use. And there you go. That is basically the whole thing that we're building. All right, so just very quickly, I just wanted to show you the actual code that I was running right there. It is very straightforward, and the code is also right there in the description if you want to take a look at it. But it's very straightforward. As you can see, I have some tools for logging. I do have this nice little banner that I showed you just a moment ago. Then we basically just start the main process where we print the banner, and then we grant folder access, which is this function right here, which takes the folder path from the user and then just adds it to the allowed directories right here. Once that happens, it goes on to the while loop, which is the agent loop. And if the user types quit, then we just get out of it. And yeah, basically that's all that work that's going on. And then we run the task until we get out of the agent workflow. And the run task function is very straightforward. All that it does is run the agent. Remember that this is how you run your agent. I did set a maximum number of turns to 30 so that it does not go working for 100 turns. And then the agent itself is also very straightforward. As I showed you before, we defined the model ID. In this case, I had actually set it to GPT-OSS. This is just the default. The base URL, I'm setting the default to Olama, which is my local host. But if you want to use Hugging Face inference providers, all you have to do is change this to router.huggingface.co.v/v1, and it will work correctly. And there you go. As I showed you before, we have this OpenAI chat completions model, which gets this async OpenAI client where we set our base URL, and then you just pass the API key if you're using Hugging Face inference providers. And then we have the agent that we just defined with the name, the very clear instructions. This is the prompt that I used to actually have the agent do what I wanted to do. As you can see, it's pretty detailed and very straightforward about what it is supposed to be able to do. It is able to create scripts, as you can see right here, and it has this very clear set of rules. And then we have the tools right here, the tools definition and the model, which is the one that I defined just above, and then we just return it. And the whole thing is wrapped inside a create agent function that we just use right here to create our agent and to import our agent, which we imported from here, from agents import runner and from agent import agent and the model ID, the base URL and the API key. And for the tools, also very straightforward, we have the allowed directories variable, which I told you that I was using to validate the directories that my agent wants to access to. And here we have the allowed commands that we want to be able to give our agent access to, so very straightforward commands. and we have the blocked patterns that we do not want it to be able to use. So we don't want it to do sudo or anything like that. So this is all blocked. And then we have some very rudimentary security guardrails right here to extract the base commands, to validate the commands, to validate a path in the command. And then we have the three tools that I showed you, which is the run shell tool, which I already explained to you how it works. And then we have these open two, these other two web tools, which is the fetch URL, which just scrapes whichever URL you send to it. And then we have the search web tool, which basically just uses DuckDuckGo, as I was telling you. So there you go. That is the whole thing. Very, very minimalist way to code an alternative to Cloud Code or to Cloud Cowork, and to have it run actions in any directory that you want in your desktop and in your computer. So thank you very much for watching. Let me know if you want to see more local model tutorials like this one, and if you have any questions, I'll be right there in the comments to answer them. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.